Welcome to a Crate Control video tutorial series. In this video, we'll be covering some more advanced concepts that you should know before using Crate Control in your live show productions. We'll begin by talking about sound object positioning mechanics. Soundscape is based on a Cartesian coordinate system, or X and Y axes, which allows you, as the user, to place a sound object to represent a real-world performer position. For example, if we know that this singer is actually 3 meters upstage, we can type that in here and perfectly position that sound object to match the performer on stage. Positioning in Crate Control can be done offline without a connection to a Soundscape processor or without any knowledge of the system configuration. In this case, all positioning choices are made in the abstract. That is to say, positions are relative to each other with an assumed scale. Once Crate Control is connected to a processor, the pre-programmed positions can then be rescaled on the fly, making it very easy to adapt the offline positions to the real-world positions of the entire show. Next, let's discuss the point of origin. For those already familiar with the DMB workflow, the point of origin will not be a new concept. However, for newcomers, the point of origin is specified in ArrayCalc for the DBPR file and is typically the front and center edge of the stage. By default, Crate Control sets the project's point of origin at the front and center edge of the example venue. However, when importing from a DBPR file, the point of origin may change. The point of origin defines the zero position for the X and Y axes, and thus for the grid in the viewport. If after importing from a DBPR file, your point of origin has moved, you can use the project scaling function in the project settings page to adjust the point of origin. Crate Control communicates with the Soundscape processor using the OCA protocol, just like R1. Because of this, Crate Control can run within a network that includes other traffic such as Danta or Milan, as long as all switches and infrastructure can accommodate 1 gigabit per second bandwidth. Once connected to the Soundscape processor, in order to push your pre-programmed show file to the processor, you must first recall a snapshot. Additionally, when Crate Control is connected to a Soundscape processor, all data will be pulled from the processor. This includes the following parameters, such as on-scene parameters, like position, spread level, and space send and delay mode, and on-space master settings, like room selection, pre-delay factor, rear level, and zone send levels. This behavior is carefully considered to include situations where a user may want to restart the control computer during an event without disturbing any of the active settings. Once your project is set and ready to go, it's time to save. When saving, your data is stored in a lightweight DBCC file. It's important to note that the settings on the parameters panel in the Soundscape view will not be stored without a snapshot. This is because Crate Control will read those parameters from a connected Soundscape processor. However, once stored in a snapshot, they can be recalled at any time. It is therefore recommended that you store at least one snapshot in your Crate Control project after setting the object parameters to your desired values. It's important to note that DBPR files, sometimes referred to as ArrayCalc or R1 project files, and DBCC files are not cross-compatible. However, a DBPR file can be imported into your Crate Control project to provide you with time-saving assets such as the venue geometry and sound objects with names. To do so, simply click the hamburger menu, click Import from DBPR, select the DBPR file you'd like to use, and choose whether you'd like to import the venue, the sound objects, or none. Once imported, we see that all of the objects are located at the point of origin. Once connected to a Soundscape processor, Crate Control will read the positions of the objects from the connected processor. This is a great opportunity to take a snapshot of the current system state. Additionally, if there are other snapshots stored in another software, such as R1 and Snap or QLab, you can transfer them to Crate Control by recalling the snapshot in the external software and then creating a new snapshot in Crate Control with those positions and parameter values. In case you've forgotten to save your project, no worries. Crate Control will create an autosave every minute if a change has been made to the project. To access them, click the hamburger menu, Autosaves, and you'll see the last 5 autosaves that were created. click the one that you'd like to reload, and you're back in action. You can also use the autosaves like an undo function in case you've made a recent change that you'd like to restore. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one.